Hi there all, and thanks again for joining me for another episode of the Contemporary Bowron. Today, we're going to work on the fundamental double-ended role. Now, you're probably thinking, what the hell is he talking about? Well, what I'm referring to is that embellishment that people often call a double-ended triplet. This embellishment looks like this. Now, you're going to notice several things in this double-ended role. First, there's the basic structure. The number 3 over top of the 3/16th notes is what's known as a triplet sign. Now, all this means is that 3/16th notes happen in the amount of time that 2/16th notes would normally happen. Then we have the sticking. The first note of the embellishment is a downstroke, which for this exercise I've colored red. Next, we have a new kind of stroke that I call a top stroke, in which we're going to utilize the top of the tipper for the first time so far. This stroke is colored blue in the example. Thirdly, we have an upstroke, which is colored green in the example. Lastly, we finish up our 4-stroke embellishment on the 8th note with an instroke, which is black in the notation. I find that a good way for me, at least, to remember how this embellishment goes is to say down top up in, down top up in that kind of triplet-y rhythm. Let's talk about the mechanics now for a second. So I'm going to break down the fundamental double-ended role into 4 building blocks. First, we're going to play just a downstroke, which is that red note. Make sure you start that downstroke in that set position, with the tipper parallel to the ground, and finish the stroke in the down position. Next, we're going to play the first 2 strokes of the embellishment, so the downstroke and the top stroke, or the red and the blue notes. What we're going to do is play the downstroke with a good amount of velocity, while relaxing this hand at the same time, which will let the top end of the tipper actually make contact with the skin. For you drummers out there, this is going to produce a flam-type sound on the skin. Third, we're going to add an upstroke to the downstroke and the top stroke that we've built up so far. So down top up, down top up. If you're following along with the notation, that's red blue green, red blue green. And last, we'll add an instroke, or the black note, to our down top and upstroke to finish out the embellishment. Now, in actual use, this fundamental 4-stroke double-ended role is played a bit tighter than a true triplet spacing. That's why I said the triplet in quotes before. But for now, let's just concentrate on each of the 4 building blocks within our process. You'll be playing this embellishment in no time if you work on it systematically, and then we can work on adjusting the overall looseness or tightness of those first 3/16th notes so that we can more closely mirror the way that melody players will tend to execute their embellishments. I'll do each building block nice and slow with the metronome set to around 66 beats a minute. Then in the next episode, I'm going to do the whole embellishment with the metronome at 3 different increasing tempos.